So happy to have you here today, Rob, at AHR. We appreciate you coming down and visiting us.
Yeah, thanks.
So tell us a little bit about yourself.
Okay, Rob Lifrith. Like I said, I've been in AHR for almost 20 years. Always in the state of Utah, kind of born and raised in total Homer. I got into it on a fluke. Back in college, I had a professor invite me to go to HR and do an HR class. I did well in it, and it started to roll from there. I've kind of focused on startups my whole professional career. So for me, I like that because it gives you an opportunity to build. It gives you an opportunity to start from scratch and do it the way that is right. And it's never right. Like, it's always depending on your company size. You're always tweaking on it because what you put in place for a company at 25 is going to be different than what you put in place for a company at 250.
Yeah, talking about companies, you co-founded Alta Scout.
Yeah.
Can you tell us a little bit about that company?
Yeah, so Alta Scout was a brainchild of a couple other, there's a couple of us that have been in HR for a long time. Myself, Trent Staley, who was the CTO of Avicom Pro, and Paul Alstrom. Who was over at Alta Ventures. And the issue that we saw with recruiting, with HR in startups, is that startup companies never really had a good resource for recruiting. They couldn't afford it, to be quite honest with you. It just wasn't in the budget. And so we stripped it down to back to the studs on what a recruiting firm should look like, and we changed a bunch of things. We wrapped the whole process in technology, so it's the recruiting process is automated, mostly automated, and then we completely redesigned the fees, and so we got away from all commissions, and we just charge an hourly rate the way you would with your accountant or your lawyer, and the results have been awesome. We're hiring people. Engineers, the last time we did it, hired an engineer. One of the last engineers we hired was like $3,500 versus our competitors are charging 20 grand.
Wow.
And so we make money, startups can afford it, and it's the way it should be. One of our things we say internally is just because people have already agreed to pay, the market's proven that companies will pay a ridiculous amount of money for talent, it doesn't mean they should, right? Because when you go and when people are looking for or calling a recruiter, usually they're desperate. And we just don't want to take advantage of somebody in their hour of desperation. And so that's the brainchild. That's how we go. We've been going around for about a year and a half. It's been going great.
That's awesome. As an HR consultant, what are some processes that any company should be have in place or be put in place?
So the way that I look at it is that, particularly now, the market's tight. You are competing whether if you are in oil and gas or you are in, it doesn't matter really what industry, you are all competing for the same person, right? So if you're trying to find an accountant, you're competing against every different industry. And so you have to think really people focused. Why do people want to commit 8 hours plus a day to come and be at that company? And so you need to think through how they're treated when they're recruited, how they're treated once they're in. What's their experience when they go through things like payroll and benefits and all the different things that touch them on a day-to-day basis? And you have to make that process smooth, right? Your goal at the end of the day as an HR person is to keep their butt in a seat so they're able to do their job, right? So that means taking care of all distractions, so it's a good process for them.
Cool. When consulting with a new company, what are the first things you look at and why?
I start, I start at the beginning, when coming into a company, what does that process look like? And then you start there and you take them all the way to fruition, like what does it look like when they terminate? So you go through each one of the processes and you understand what that employee experience is like, for all the way from candidate experience to employee experience on the other side. How great would it be, even on a termination, whether it's someone that quits or someone that you end up having to terminate, that you're thinking of that person as an alumni rather than someone that just used to work here, right? And if you can make that, it's a subtle switch in your mindset, but if you can do that, then you're really helping how people will look at your company long term and how they perform while they're inside and how they talk about your company afterwards, because whether you like it or not, that's going to happen, right? The reputation, an employer reputation is critical these days. You can't get around anymore. The internet will kill you otherwise.
Yeah, I love that. I love the thought of thinking about employees as alumni, whether they work there or not, especially, you know, after they leave. I think every company wants their company to be a dream job, but right. Sometimes it's a stepping stone.
Sure.
We know companies and some of our customers, they actually have events and parties and pool parties and different things where they invite anyone that's ever worked there. They welcome them back and their families, which is cool.
Yeah, I think that's the right mentality. If you can set up a culture that way, you're marching down the right path for sure.
That's awesome. What role does HR play in the overall company or business objectives?
That's an interesting question. I think this is one thing that I think HR has changed. Like if you had asked that question 10 years ago, you know, the answer would have been much more transactional. HR professionals need to look at themselves as a business accelerator, right? So HR professionals need to know what the company strategies are, and they need to know, you know, where the company's going and why they're going there, because if they know that, then anything that they do from a process, procedure, employee engagement standpoint, it should be fueling the direction and the success of the company rather than just, hey, they got to, you know, do these transactional items. It should be accelerating what the business is doing. That makes sense?
Absolutely. Yeah, bonus question. You ready for this one?
Go.
What's one thing you wish you would have done differently?
In my career? I went down the HR and IT path. I have a separate degree in information systems, and I went down the IT path first. And while it's been helpful, right, you know, certainly I wish I would just gone to HR and just ran. I like dealing with people. I like that part of things. So the other thing that I wish I tell people that they should do differently, don't try and jump ahead in your career too soon. A lot of people are like, they try to get that next promotion too soon. What ends up happening is they get over their skis and they fail. And there's nothing, and that's harder to come back for than being patient and learning a little bit more. Because right. in the grand scheme of things, another year, well, seeing that's a long time. In your career standpoint, it's not, right? So if you are patient a little bit longer and learn more from those that are above you, I think that pays off dividends down the road.
Where are you from? Where'd you grow up?
I grew up in Layton, Utah.
What high school?
Northridge.
Tell us about your family.
Family. So I came from a group of, there's six siblings. I'm the third of six. We are four boys, two girls, and it was a fun group. We're still super tight. Like, my best friends are my siblings right now.
That's awesome.
And
that's rare.
It is rare. And we all get along, like, still, like, you know, we got together on Saturday and it was just, you know, it's just what you do. It's fun. So,
any great traditions or things you do or things your mom or dad that you continue to do in your family?
We love all things. If it has to do with water, we love it. Right. So, you know, being on a lake, being on a boat, being like anywhere, ocean, like, it's great. So that's what we do. And we are always up for an adventure, which usually ends up in a broken bone or something like that. And like, we have to remind ourselves how old we are, because like, maybe we wouldn't have gotten hurt, you know, 15 years ago, but that's what we do.
That's awesome. Well, congratulations on all your success. We love you over here at HR. It's been great to have you in. Appreciate it.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks.
All right, brother. Thanks for coming.
Yeah.